The beer chosen to accompany tonight's Mailbag Monday is Nonsuch Brewing's Baltic Porter. Not much for tasting notes on the can, but if I remember correctly from the last time I had this, it is quite roasty, but not as thick a mouthfeel as a lot of the traditional porters that you find brought in from the UK. Still, a very nice pint. Very nice indeed. Oh look, it's a pile of mail. What should I start with? Oh, let's start with the one that's on the top. This has no description. Well, it does, but it's in Chinese. So we will be surprised together. It's a package of drill bits. I think these are probably going to be metric drill bits, because those are a little bit, like everything else metric, they're a little bit harder to find and more expensive around here. So five different sizes. Let's see if I can read the largest one. No markings of any kind on the shaft. Well, so I'm not expecting these to be super high quality, of course, but I'm most likely going to be using these for plastic, for maybe aluminum, maybe wood. So they're not going to be, getting a hard life, especially these smallest ones. Suppose I could measure them, or I could just go and look at the listing to find out what they are. So 50 pieces HSS, which I think is high-speed steel, cobalt twist drill bits, HSS-Co for hard metal stainless steel, 1 millimeter up to 3 millimeters. I got these from Call Me Beauty, a trusted name in drill bits and industrial supplies, no doubt. They're currently selling for $4.59 American, $6 Canadian with free shipping. But of course, that's changed since I bought it. Back when I bought it, it was $4.82 Canadian with free shipping. They don't have a description, but the reviews of them aren't all that awesome. The best rated review is, they seem to get the job done. Right. Like I said, I wasn't expecting much, and I'm not planning on using these for cutting through the hardest of materials. So they should serve the purpose, especially at the price. Next item in is nuts. Okay. I'm hoping that it's not food. It probably isn't. Nope, it's nuts and screws. Continuing on from the theme from last week and from earlier already, these are M3 by 10 millimeter long, M3 by 5 millimeter long, and I'm assuming those are M3 nuts as well. So this is just, as I said, continuing on. Metric hardware is hard to find for a reasonable price around locally, so I'm just stocking up as I'm finding them relatively affordably on eBay. M2/M2.5/M3 Phillips round panhead washer head machine screws, A304, A2, stainless steel. From GLHK04. Sure. 30 pieces of the 5mm, I paid $1.63 for. The 10mm, $2.16. They didn't have shipping on them when I bought them, which is one of the reasons why I chose the seller at the time. And from the same seller, whose name I'm not going to try and pronounce again, a copper-plated M2.5. Oh, shit. Did I actually do that? I hope I didn't. Anyways, copper-plated nuts. I hope I... Oh, that's why. Yeah, I actually did order M3, but they're out of stock at the moment. Okay, fine. Be like that. Anyways, $1.54 is what I paid for them. $1.40 right now. That might just be currency fluctuations, though.
Oh, good. I did actually get M3 nuts. Oh, I was worried there for a second. That really is quite nice and roasty. From the UK, we have, what does this say in this nice shiny package? Machinery parts. That's adequately vague. I wonder why it's in a shiny little bag. Wow. Anyway, getting distracted by shiny things. This is a little motorized pump. Oh, right, I remember. Okay, we'll check the listings and I'll get back to this in a second here.
DC 5-volt, 6-volt, micro 370 vacuum air pump, self-priming suction negative pressure pump. That kind of reads like a standard Chinese listing, doesn't it? And yeah, it seems to have come, well, it was ordered from somebody in Hong Kong, but they shipped it from the UK. Fine, fair enough. I paid $3.85 Canadian from Hello Allen. And yes, this is supposed to be, hopefully, a vacuum pump. It also claims to be used, so I hope it actually works. Does it say here 5 to 6 volts between 320 and 400 milliamps? Okay, 60 grams, yeah. Not much else to say.
So, the reason that I bought this, I'm trying to figure out the best way to store my 3D printing filament. And a lot of people are suggesting store it in a dry environment to keep the filament from degrading. So for now, that is just a large Ziploc bag full of a whole bunch of desiccant packs, like every desiccant pack I get my hands on. But every time I take a spool of filament out or put it back in, I want to suck as much of the air out as possible just to give the desiccant a fighting chance. So far, I've just been using a straw and my mouth to do that, but that's barbaric. So I'm going to try and use this. Oh yeah, there is definitely suction on there. And there's pressure there too. What do we got? Install at 460 milliamps. And when it's free running, 260. Okay. Yeah, it's doing the business. That should suck in a good way. Nice. So then the next two things that were sent in from some of you guys. This particular one came from Patrick in Quebec to my P.O. box. So let us see what Patrick has generously donated. Ooh, there is a note. And there is a kit. Ah, okay. This is not the first time Patrick has sent me something. Patrick's a guy in Quebec who's selling small kits on eBay. And this is the second one that he sent me to take a peek at. For my kit building specials, it is a simple sine wave generator that uses a 555 to generate a square wave. And then it's modified through a LC tank network to create a sine wave. Yeah. I think I've played with something similar to that before. And he says there's no real use for this other than learning one of the many, many ways to use a 555. But if you want a relatively cheap sine wave for as a test signal, that's not a bad way of going about it. Let's just take a quick peek in here. So we have, of course, the 555. We have an inductor. We have three capacitors and a resistor. And that is, usually you want two resistors. Ah, the inductor is probably in place of one of the resistors in the voltage divider. Nice little board, black solder mask. Yeah, nice little board. I will throw that together in a future video. Actually, I may toss both of his kits together in the same video, because they're both relatively straightforward, fairly beginner-friendly kits. Yeah, I think I'll do that. And I think I mentioned before, I'm intending on doing a bunch of kit build videos for December. So stay tuned for that. Just to help out a fellow Canadian, here's Patrick's eBay store where he's selling this kit. So he's selling it for $6.95 Canadian, plus shipping, of course. Because Canada Post won't let anybody do anything for free around here. Here's the board built up. It's a very tidy little board. There's some decent looking sine waves out of it as well. That's excellent. It's going to be a fixed frequency sine wave because the inductor and capacitor are going to select for a very specific frequency. But that's fine. Nothing wrong with having a good little test waveform. I'll be interested to see what frequency comes out of this thing. Suppose we could do the math, but it's just as easy to throw it together as a beginner kit and measure it and see what happens. And one more from one of you guys. Looks like somebody ordered whatever this is, voice module, it says. Looks like they ordered it from China, from probably eBay, maybe, and had it shipped to me, which is very kind of them. But with that, I'm probably not going to ever find out who my generous benefactor is. Connie is probably the name of the person at the cellar, but whatever. What do we have in here? It is a kit, I think, with LEDs on it. Okay, we have some jumper wires. We have a flat flex cable. We have a connector that mates with that, and that'll be what those go into. And we have some standoff pillars. We have a fairly heavy duty little circuit board there. So we've got a bunch of 12 50-50 LEDs. They look like they've got six connections on them, so they may be RGB. I'm not sure. But each pair of them around the outside here has this little CAN module here, which might be some kind of a microphone thing. I think I've seen these before. Oh, okay. Duh. Yeah, it's even seeing there. It's showing microphones down there. Okay. A couple of little ICs there. Is this one of those directional sensing microphone things? But it obviously needs some kind of something or other to connect to. I'm going to have to do some research on this guy and figure out exactly what it is. That's not all that helpful. Oh, maybe. LC-A1-K210-7 mic. 7? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, there's a seventh one in the middle. Okay. Microphone data, LED clock, and data. This is going to take some research. Okay, well, it wasn't actually that hard to find the thing. I just typed in exactly the numbers off the bag, and it brought me pretty much the first or second hit on the old Googler. It took me here. So 6+1 I2S microphone array. I2S is, I think, a data protocol similar to I2C, but different. Again, more research. Microphone array module, voice recognition, programmable, RGB, dev board accessory. That's definitely the one. So, 6+1 microphone array with 7 silicone microphones, 12 programmable LEDs, supports right and left channel, 3-channel, blah, 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 I2S again. Okay, 20 kilohertz bandwidth, interesting. 1 to 4 megahertz clock frequency, 12 cascaded SK9822 LEDs. Oh, these are SPI controlled. Okay. Clock data, power and ground. Yeah, I've heard of these or something similar before. So you don't need the precise timing that you need with WS2812s. Because you can just set the data bit and clock it at whatever speed you want, up to some reasonable maximum, I'm sure. Anyway, I'm getting distracted by the blinking lights, because of course I'm getting distracted by blinking lights. I2S, inter-IC sound, a serial bus for connecting digital audio devices together. Okay, so those microphone little modules on there have a built-in modem, basically, and A to D and all kinds of good stuff, huh? And it outputs PCM audio. And fairly high quality by the sounds of it, too. I have much more research to do before I can actually play with this thing.
And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite the variety and several surprises this time. First, we'll just go quickly through the shipping times because people always ask me about that. These cheap drill bits took 31 days. The M3 hardware took 25 days.
The little vacuum, or pressure, I guess, pump took 34 days. That's the stuff that I ordered, and I know, so I have an idea of that. These two things, of course, I don't know how long they took to get here, but this one probably didn't take very long to get from Quebec to Manitoba. Thanks once again, Patrick. I'll play with that sometime in December when I'm doing a whole bunch of kit builds. And this, thanks to my anonymous benefactor, this is going to take some thinking. This is quite the little module. I'm sure somebody somewhere has projects for it online that I can shamelessly borrow their code from. Because I'm guessing that, well, there will be a library for these little microphones. That doesn't bother me. There will be a library for the LEDs. I could probably run the LEDs separately off an Arduino just to prove that I understand them. But processing all that digital audio, that's going to take some pretty skookum software, which is beyond me. So I'm hoping I can find somebody smarter than me who has already played with that so that I can experiment on my own. Oh, thanks everybody for watching. Thanks, Patrick. Thanks to my anonymous benefactor there. Thanks, as always, to my Patreon supporters who help me keep my shop stocked, keep the mailbags rolling in, and buy me a beer now and again. I appreciate that, guys. Comments and questions down below. I think I already said that, but whatever. Yeah, I will talk to you later.